here we can see quite a lot of volcanic process animated. So let's go inside. Have quite a lot of volcanic rocks. This one is a volcanic tuff. We have scoria, which is from the volcanic eruption. And so, depending on the cooling ridge, so we may have different, you know, the rocks formed. For example, this one is a basalt. We have volcanic bomb. You see, the bomb is pretty big in size. And we have agglomerate here. So depending on the mineral composition, you can have andesite for this one. The rhyolite is from the lava flow. Today we're going to see a lot of this. And obsidian is from the volcanic eruption. Is basically a phonetic glass. Well, this one is a pumice. It contains a lot of bubbles. Basically, we call it a vesicular structure. All right, here is a map, shows the surrounding area, the north, and also the east. So you can see the Shafa land all the way to the highland reservoir here. This is almost the volcanic center. So you can see when the volcano actually erupted, it has a lot of lava. So the lava cooled down and formed a thick layer. And under contraction, it formed a jointed rock. It's called columnar joints. So you know where it is? The Pobinjo. It's right over here. And also the area of highland reservoir. Another interesting thing to look at is to stand on this volcano, the edges. It's called a caldera, the boundary. So we can see quite a lot of lava flows. And also there are other type of igneous rock like a quartz, monzonite, volcanic breccia, rhyolite, etc. So this is today's site. We're going to go there. So you know what this location is? The Shafa land. Okay. All right, so actually the expert actually found it. The Hong Kong in this region was formed by a super volcano about 140 million years ago. So here in the Sai Kung area is the volcano center. Here in the Kowloon and the part of Hong Kong Island, there's magma supply path to this volcano center. So you can see here is a lot of knowledge about volcanic activities here. Here shows us some, you know, after volcanic eruption, they're very fine volcanic ashes. Can be smaller than 2 centimeters. Can be blown away by wind to a little bit far, several kilometers away, and settle down to become volcanic tuff. So this is fine ash volcanic tuff, as we can see from the HQSD campus. And we have lapalai. It's slightly bigger. And also we could have even volcanic bomb, which is a large fragments. Wow, this is good process. Look at this. So about 160 to 140 million years ago, so Hong Kong is in the range of subduction zone. You can see the crust is subducted downneath. And they have reactions here to create a volcano. So the lava, actually magma, actually is very hot here and form a magma chamber, which blow up through the wind and flow out as the lava flow. After they cooling down, actually they form a lot of interesting volcanic rocks here. So most famous one is so-called Kalaman joints. So this Kalaman joints we can observe here is quite unique for Hong Kong. Here is formed by the acid rock. In other places like the United States, they have a similar columnar joints, but mainly formed by the basaltic rock. So they're quite different in composition. So our volcanic columnar joints are kind of quite big in size. You can look at this size, it's like 2 meters across, very big, hexagonal shaped. This is due to the cooling down process. All right, so you can see the acid volcanic rock over here. All right, so let's go to the site to the Sharp Island. We are now on the Sharp Island. You see a very nice location for a lot of people having fun over here. This is Sunday. Very nice. Okay, now we are on the Sharp Island. Actually, if you look at it closely about the volcanoes, so the Sharp Island is on the edge of the most recent volcano center. The volcano will generate a lot of, you know, volcanic rocks by formed by volcanic ash and also lava flow. Here on this site we can see a lot of rock formed by the lava flow, which is called rhyolite. Another type of rock which is the intrusive, which is formed by cooling down of magma, for example the granite and quartz monzonite. On this site, we can see a lot of quartz monzonite, a very special feature in this site. So altogether, we can see the volcanic tuff, we can see rhyolite, and we can also see quartz monzonite on this site. In this location, we can see the volcanic rock are highly fractured. So they are brecciated, so you can see angular corners, very angular fragments is generated.
So this is called volcanic breccia. So let me walk around with you across this side so you can have a feeling about volcanic breccia. All right, let's go. So you can clearly see the site is brecciated. It's highly fractured and jointed. Okay, very good. So let's walk around and go to the second site, which is across the beach. Okay, let's go. All right, let's go around the beach. A lot of people have party over here. It's a very nice area for the family gathering. All right, now I'm standing on this very interesting site. So here is this very good feature of this location. This is like a pineapple barn. So if you're hungry, maybe don't attempt to eat it. So this is a quite interesting, we call it quartz monzonite. The quartz monzonite is intrusive rock. So if you look very closely, you can see two types of minerals in this rock, which is a feldspar and a quartz. So that's why the name is quartz monzonite. So because of weathering and heat and dry cooling down, so the surface generated a lot of cracks. So over the time, you can see the surface become rounded and become cracked, the beautiful pineapple shape. Also in this site, we can see quite a lot of interesting rocks with banding here and with a lot of the patterns. So this type of rock, actually we know this is called a rhyolite. So the rhyolite actually records the lava flow path during the volcanic eruption process. So this is intrusive rock. Again, this is extrusive rock. So the rhyolite has very, very fine grain size, we can see, because this extrusive rock, which cooled down very fast, so that's, it will give it a kind of a very fine grain. On another hand, this quartz monzonite actually is intrusive rock. It's cooled down quite slowly. That's why we can find very big grains of feldspar and quartz over here. So this is also another piece of rhyolite. So very interesting site we can look around. And here we have quite a lot of people standing here. And in front of you, this is the so-called tambalu. So basically you can walk across to that type of island to have a look. Because of high tide today, so we cannot go there. So still some people actually are treading the water and come back and forth. So very interesting to walk around. All right, you look at the rhyolite, okay? So did you see the flow patterns? Okay, look at this. Beautiful flow banding. Beautiful flow banding. This is quartz monzonite. If I zoom in, you can see feldspar, very large feldspars, and some quartz particles over here. Yeah, the pineapple, to give you a zoom in here, you can look at the pineapple. So quartz monzonite, some quartz particles, and also the feldspars. Very beautiful texture. Look at here. This is a rhyolite. You can see clearly see the flow over here. All right, so you can see this is a beautiful piece of a rhyolite. So clearly the flow banding is quite clear on this side. This is another piece of rhyolite. You can see the different coloring of flow banding. Another case, because it is a beautiful piece, okay? So the rhyolite actually is extrusive rock, which is actually cooled down very fast. In this site, we know the rhyolite is an acid rock. It contains the minerals and composition the same as volcanic tuff, the same as granite. So the major mineral is steel, feldspar, quartz, and mica. But the rhyolite actually records the lava flow. It's a memoir of the lava flow process. Most beautiful and spectacular on this site. All right, let's go along another side of the beach. You can see here, a lot of few people here. Okay, very nice. Alright, let's tour around this site, and you can see a lot of beautiful rhyolite. This is a pretty big one. It's all this lava flow features. This piece is almost like a 2 meter long. And you can also look at this one as well. Okay, it's pretty beautiful. This also have a very beautiful lava flow pattern. Can you see that? Very beautiful afternoon. So today we're going to stop the tour over here. Today we basically tour around the campus, HQST, and also shop our lunch around the campus, which is mainly about volcanic rocks. All right, so hope you enjoy it. Thank you. See you next time. Thank you.